Welcome to this brief guide on how to compose a post on Mastodon. Whilst Mastodon has a lot of similarities with other social networking services, there are some key differences in the feature set around how you compose a post. So today I thought I'd run us through those features and how to utilize them. Here I am in my Mastodon instance, the Universidon server, and the first thing I can create is a text post by simply clicking in the What's on Your Mind box and beginning to type my post. You'll notice I have a character limit. The character limit is dictated by the particular server that you are a member of. You can also insert emojis into your particular post, including some custom ones, such as in this case, I have the Success Kid, which is great to see. But what you'll notice underneath that lovely little What's on Your Mind box is I have a few different icons. We'll go through each and every one of these today. The first of which is the ability to add an image, a video, or even an audio file to your post. Here I'm adding a photo, and the reason I'm adding in a photo is just so I can show you a couple of the other features as well. So here I have my photo at the moment, and I notice that there's no alt text that's been added to it. So what I can do is I can click on the edit icon, and in order to make this more accessible for everybody, I can use the box here to put in a quick description as to what the actual photo is of. In this instance, it's a fog-covered mountaintop with some forests located in the lower foreground. What I also have is a lovely little dot here that I can move around to select the focal point of my image to ensure that that focal point is always inside the preview, regardless of which device a user is looking at my post on. And then when they click on the full photo, they'll be able to see that. One of the other options that I have available to me here is the ability to mark the media as sensitive. So if the content that you are posting could potentially offend other users, it may be useful to use the tick box to mark that media as sensitive to have it blurred in the general timeline. Now I'll delete that photo, and we're going to add in the second option here, which is the ability to make a poll. Just like other services, I can put in my question into the text box at the top, and then I can have the options to put in my individual choices for my poll. I can even use the Add a Choice button to add in some additional choices. And I even have the ability to give my poll a specific time frame. So for instance, anywhere from 5 minutes all the way up to 1 week. In this demo, I'm going to create a 6-hour little post here. Now, on top of all of these options, I will remove those. We're going to go to the next option here, which is the change post privacy. This is something that's key to know how you can control your information. So at the moment, my default is for my posts to be public, which is visible to all, but I do also have the option to make them unlisted, which means that they will technically be visible, but they will not show up in things such as the search and discovery feature set. There are also options to make it so it's visible only for people who follow me or only for people that I mention in the post. Now, if I was to select one of these options and then choose that I don't want that option anymore, I can simply select that icon and then change it back to public in this instance. The next one is a feature that's very, very useful inside Mastodon, which is a content warning. So you can put in your own particular warning here. So for instance, if you were to be making a lovely little post about a movie and you don't want to give anybody any spoilers, you can make the content warning say movie spoilers, and then a user will need to click on and link in order to be able to see the spoiler that you have put inside your post. This is a great way to be able to make sure that you're not spoiling particular movies or things like that for other users. It's also useful for things such as political conversations if you don't want to offend people as well. The last option that we have is our post language. Now this is a great feature because it's a feature that Mastodon makes use of with filtering options. So you can dictate the language that you are posting your post in. So this is great for people who may potentially use multiple languages. And selecting our default options, we can be done via the preferences page. So opening up the preferences page will by default take us to our appearance settings. But just underneath there, we have an option that says other. So we're going to select the option for other. And then inside here, we have our posting defaults, including our default privacy, which for me, as you can see, is public. And my posting language is the same as my interface language, which in this case is English. And you can choose whether or not to always mark your photos as sensitive, should you wish. Using the drop-down menu, I can simply choose from the large selection of languages. In this case, I'm going to say potentially if I wanted, I could change it so that my default is always in French, if I was a person that posted in French. In my case, I'm just going to leave it back as the default, which was the same as interface language. The reason this is useful is the option down the bottom here when I scroll down is that people can choose to filter their public timelines to only show posts that have been dictated as being in a select language. So if you wish, you could potentially choose, say for instance, English, Japanese, and Korean, if those are the languages that you speak, so that in your timeline, you will only see content that has been tagged as those options. Be sure to click on Save Changes if you make any changes to these settings. And that is how you compose a post on Mastodon. I hope you found these tips extremely useful and it makes your Mastodon experience just a little bit better, and I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.